This is Pastor Din Padayag. Welcome to Soul Food. This is Pastor Din Padayag. Welcome to Soul Food. We are continuing with our series on the work of the Holy Spirit as part of our lesson on the provision from God. And today we will talk about the word conviction. Now, as we go to the early Acts ministry of the Holy Spirit, we see that the nation of Israel is being convicted of their national sins for rejecting the Lord Jesus Christ as their God and their Messiah. And that's actually the center of the message of Apostle Peter during the day of Pentecost in Acts chapter 2, verse 23. The Bible says, "Him being delivered by the determined purpose and foreknowledge of God, you have taken by lawless hands and have crucified and put to death." In verse 36, the Bible says, "Therefore let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made this Jesus, whom you have crucified, both Lord and Christ." Now the Holy Spirit uses this message of Peter to convict the people of Israel of their sinfulness and unrighteousness, as well as their worthiness of God's judgment. In Acts chapter 2, verse 37, the Bible says, "Now when they heard this," that gospel that Peter preached of charging them of their guilt of committing that act of crucifying Jesus Christ and not receiving Him as their God and Savior. And so when they heard about this gospel, that message, the Bible says that they were cut to the heart and they were asking Peter and the rest of the apostles of what they are going to do. And Peter answered in Acts chapter 2, verse 38, "Repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins." Peter said, you have to repent, you have to change your mind, you have to change your action. And that was the response that they had to do to the message that Peter preached to them. And that repentance must also be demonstrated with the act of submitting to water baptism. They have to repent and be baptized, and only then that God will accept that act of faith as a response to the gospel that Peter preached to them. Now, how about in our time in the dispensation of grace? How does the Holy Spirit convict a person or people in our time? Well, the answer is through the Word of God. Always through the Word of God. Always through the gospel that is for our time. Romans chapter 10, verse 17 gives us the example. "So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God." What is this word of God that Apostle Paul is talking about? Is he talking about repent and be baptized? No, that's not the gospel for our time. First of all, we are not guilty of crucifying the Messiah. It was the people of Israel who crucified the Lord Jesus Christ, and so they were guilty of that sin, and so they had to repent and then be baptized. The message of repentance and baptism, that's not the gospel for our salvation in the time of grace. You can repent a million times. You can change your mind a million times. You can even submit to water baptism a thousand times, if not a million times. But that will not save you. That will not give you that eternal life and salvation that God has promised to those who believe in Him. That's not the gospel for us today. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7, Colossians 1:14, Romans 3:24, all of these verses talk about how we can be saved in our time. It says, we have redemption or salvation through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ and the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of His grace. Not because we killed Him, not because that we are guilty of crucifying the Savior, but the gospel for our time is that Christ died, was buried, and rose again. And that is an act of grace in the part of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because of His love and grace, He gives Himself willingly to us. Not that we committed sin of crucifying Him, but whatever happened to Jesus Christ on the cross, He turned it around and made it a good news for us. And He's not charging us of guilt of crucifying Him, but instead, He offered Himself to us. He gives grace to us and gave Himself for us willingly. And so, the gospel is capsuled in 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4. Christ died for our sins. He was buried and rose again. That is grace, beloved. And that is the gospel of our salvation. And through the convicting power of the Holy Spirit, He would convict us of our personal sins, not national sins, unlike the people of Israel, that they were guilty of a national sin in rejecting and not believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. Us, the Holy Spirit will convict us of our personal sins. And if we put our trust and faith in that finished work of grace or finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can be saved and we will receive the forgiveness of our sins. So the work of the Holy Spirit in convicting people of their sins, it's still very important in our time. You cannot be saved unless you recognize that you are a sinner and you are in need of a Savior. Beloved, we don't have a lot of time, but we will continue this series tomorrow. Thank you very much for watching and enjoy your soul food.